Oh, that's gonna be interesting.
Guys!
Welcome back, Squid Squad. Not sure if I let you know that's what I'm calling us now. Squid Squad. It's a community. If you happen to be curious to find out where I've been or what I've been doing, then check out my previous 3 videos. And if you don't care, I don't care either. I know that I have a lot of reactions to catch up on, a lot of requests, and I'm actually playing around with the idea of doing like all of them or like a series of them during like live streams to just knock them all out. I want to start over with a clean slate. I just hate having that giant document with those requests and knowing like I'm never gonna get to these video by video. And instead of trying to chip away at that, I decided to just go to the trending section today and see what I can find. I kind of want just a new start. So the first music video I see is official video Deck the Halls Pentatonix. I don't know if I've ever revealed this to you guys, but I like, just as a standard, hate acapella music. I know I've done like 2 Pentatonix reactions and they impressed me greatly. They took something that I hate as a staple and made me think it was pretty cool and actually like it. So I don't anticipate not liking this. They've wowed me up to this point. Another thing though, I hate Christmas music. So I hate acapella, I hate Christmas music, but again, this is Pentatonix, so I think they're gonna make me go, oh, this is good. So let's check it out. Wait a minute. Okay. My mind is trying to figure out what's happening here. I think I remember hearing, maybe reading in the comment threads of the last Pentatonix reaction I did. Cause I don't see how else I'd come across Pentatonix news. I thought I remember one of the guys was no longer in the group. So I expected to see like one less person right now. But instead I'm seeing, I think all the same original 4, but now another guy. So what's happening? I thought they were one less person. Now it looks like there's one extra. So people, let me hear what's going on. What's the latest news? I mean, I could Google it, but this is better. I like people to just hand me information instead of me having to go search for it. I know that, I mean, I'm not trying to doubt their skills or like say they're fake or lip syncing or anything like that, but I always have like several moments throughout. I just spit. I don't know if the camera caught that. I always have moments all throughout Pentatonix songs of like, I know they do all the instruments with their mouths, but no, this part has to be a real instrument because people can't do this sound with their mouths. I know I'm wrong because they don't do that, right? There's never like, okay, group, we're going to do 98% of the instruments with our mouths, but we're going to have a little of it be real instruments. They don't do that, right? It's all 100%, no doubt, their mouths making those noises. Because I just, it's like no matter how many times I hear it or I read about it and, you know, that's what they do, it's like, but no, I can hear. That can't be their mouth. I just can't process that. It sounds too much like an instrument. I'm liking that guy's mustache. I don't know if it's like an ironic mustache or if he's like proud of it, but I like it. Ironically. I know that, like, because they're an a cappella group, zooming up on their mouths is like equivalent to zooming in on a guitar player's hands when he's shredding, or a piano player's hands when he's doing something cool, or a bassist's hands when he's slapping the bass.
Slapping that bass, man!
But like, the close-ups on these mouths is like so cringy to me. I don't like it. It's like too intimate or something. I don't know. I just don't like staring at people's teeth and mouths and tongues, and it's kind of unsettling for me. I don't know, I personally am not a fan of that aspect of Pentatonix, because I think they do that in like all their stuff. And I really don't like seeing mouths that close up in this context. Ever. Especially with that mustache. I just completely forgot up until this point in the video that I'm listening to a Christmas song. It just completely like left my mind. I've been so immersed into their mouth instruments and the close-ups of their teeth and all the different cuts and everything, that it wasn't until like 2 seconds ago I was like, oh, this is Deck the Halls. They're just that good at getting me lost into what they're singing about, even though I didn't realize what they were singing about. I'm not making any sense. My ears are just into the noises their mouths are making as opposed to the lyrical content.
Guys, we hope you enjoyed our cover of Deck the Halls. You can get that on a Pentatonix Christmas Deluxe on Apple.
Pentatonix? I think I always say Pentatonix. Also, how come no one corrected me?
He's our bass that is joining us this holiday season. We hope you guys loved the song. We love you so much. Also, we're going on tour.
Woo!
So you can get tickets, ptxofficial.com/tour.
Yes.
We love
So he's some guy that's just joining them for the tour. But that doesn't answer my question about what happened to the whole thing about they lost a member. Was there like drama and they figured it out and now he's back? What did I miss? So yeah, like I said, I don't like Christmas music. I don't like a cappella. And not only do I not like those things, I really dislike those things. But I've learned that Pentatonix is one of those things where it's like objectively good. So it's not a matter of, I mean, like taste aside, when something's good, it's just good. And their talent isn't even like a matter of it takes me from hating it to just being indifferent. It actually makes me bob my head and go, ooh, I'm into this. Now, once it's over, I might never think about it again. Like, I guarantee you that I'm never gonna be like going through my day and think, I'm gonna go put on Pentatonix. I'm in the mood for that right now. That's never gonna happen. Like, while I'm listening to it, I'm wowed. I'm impressed, I'm entertained, I can dig it. But I'm never gonna seek it out. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I think people have so many of their own likes and tastes to keep them occupied that it's not really an insult to like Pentatonix that I'm not gonna go looking for them. other than doing a reaction. It's like pizza. Pizza is unbelievable. But if it's up to me, I'm gonna eat Chinese food every day. No diss to pizza, but there's no comparison for me personally. I don't know if that makes sense to you guys. I just really like food, so that metaphor is like on point for me. I think I'm just trying to articulate that I'm not like being a phony, because that's important to me. I'm not gonna try to be like, oh, I just discovered this and now I love Pentatonix and I'm gonna put them on my iPod. It's not like that. Like I said, I guarantee you I'm not gonna go looking for them in my off hours. But right now, when I reacted to it, I liked it. This video is sponsored by Voto Studios. When you have a moment, please go and check them out. Any support that you show Voto Studios, you show me as well. And if you look here, you'll see why. Don't you? You see it? Get it? I'm also probably more active now than I've ever been on Instagram. So if you care to follow me on social media, check out my Instagram. I also have a Facebook and a Twitter. I really need to get those going. They're kind of dead right now, but I'm going pretty good on Instagram, I think, and I follow back. I will have the social media links in the description below. Now, I want to take a moment to acknowledge some of the comments on one of my more recent videos, the White Eskimo Harry Styles Before the Fame reaction. Josephine W said, and this comment is edited, and we all know you can never trust an edited comment, but it's the top comment, so I'm gonna read it anyway, just, you know, in the future. Come on, let's keep it together. I love this reaction. I have never seen anyone on YouTube react to White Eskimo before, so this made me so happy. That actually made me feel really good. I can't believe, like, these idiots, like these other reactors. Come on, KSI? Dylan will obviously not participate. I mean, come on, we have prime material here, Dylan. White Eskimo? Harry Styles? No one? Is this market wide open just for me? Come on, this is easy pickings. I mean, I'm happy to be the only reactor in the world covering White Eskimo. I mean, come on, this is some good stuff here. I shouldn't be talking about this because now people are gonna go do it, but I can't believe people haven't jumped on this already. This is gold. So I'm gonna do all the other ones. I might edit this out. I shouldn't be talking about this because Dylan's gonna come out with it tomorrow. He's gonna ruin my whole thing. But I'm gonna keep doing them. I think it's so cool. It's so crazy that I'm the only one. I haven't checked recently. Maybe a bunch of other people have already hopped on it. Hopefully not. But to know that I was the only one that's done it blows my mind. I think that's so cool. And as far as I know, and I'm seeing it right now in the sidebar, that's what reminded me, I think I'm the only person as well that covered the behind the scenes album documentary. I don't think anyone else has done that. Let me know if they have. I'm just like, yeah. I love seeing old clips of Harry and the other boys. I mean, of course he's grown so much and evolved as a person and a singer, songwriter, performer, but I think you can still see in this clip that he was meant to be a star. I love him so much. Obviously, I mean, I think we've all seen our share of like amateur bands, high school bands, whatever. And you can already tell when you're looking at this guy right here, this child, that yeah, he's gonna grow up to be a star. It's that thing like you don't know what it is, but you know he's got it. That's exactly what's going on here. It was pretty cool to watch. Another thing, I was kind of sad. I don't think anybody noticed it. At the end of this video, I outroed it with a White Eskimo song. Time. You look around the same time. And no one acknowledged that. I was kind of sad. Whatever, I got over it. But the outro song is a White Eskimo song. And I thought someone was going to be like, ah, I see what you did there. And nobody did. JM says, not to burst your bubble, but a lot of directioners knew this. I saw a comment of this sort pop up quite a bit. I mean, a lot of people were saying things like that, and people quickly came to my defense, and that made me feel good. It kind of did, and it kind of didn't, because on one hand, I was like, I think I'm a good actor. I fooled some of these people, and then other people were like, hello, he's being funny. He obviously knew that we all knew this. But let me check the replies here. I think some people came to my defense. Yeah, like Rose 1019B was like, I'm pretty sure he knows. He was just joking. And then other people are like, exactly, I know, right? Yeah, yeah, okay. But I thought that was funny. A lot of people thought that I really didn't know that you guys knew about White Eskimo. I thought that was funny. And then Sleepy Ghost has a bunch of happy, laughing faces. I'm not up to date with my emojis. I'm not really sure if there's actual definitions for each one, but this is the one where you're like crying because you're laughing so hard. I love your reactions. You were smiling so much. And I was very self-conscious when I was editing the video because I felt like I was smiling a little too much and I felt kind of weird. I actually almost scrapped this video because I was fanboying too hard and I didn't want public record of that. So yeah, you are correct. I was a little embarrassed, but whatever. We've all been there. You're in the same place as me when you watch this stuff. It's just that I'm a weirdo and I record it so that you can all watch it. I want to say thank you more times than I can in one video. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And I'm sorry. So many of you just showed so much love in my hiatus and you totally encouraged me to come back. The amount of support that you showed just made me realize what I was missing. And I can't believe I'm glad I took the break though, because now I feel like I realize what we have here. So I actually think it was for the best. I think I have a much better mindset now. I feel really good about what I'm doing and I appreciate, and gosh, I know every YouTuber says this and so much of the time it feels so fake, but I hope this doesn't come across that way. I really absolutely appreciate every single one of you. I can't even tell you. And I try to be as active as I possibly can in the comment section so we can go back and forth, and I'll try to do the same on social media because I really want you to know how important your feedback and your support is to me. So thank you. If you're not subscribed, if you've been freeloading and you've been watching my content and you're not subscribed, please subscribe, help me out, support me, let me know that I'm not crazy and that I should keep going strong and that you're gonna actually watch the videos. If you would be so kind, I would love it if you would like, comment, subscribe, and turn that bell on. Come on, I do it for my favorite people. I would like to be one of your favorite people. At least on YouTube. See you guys next time.